the quick selection tool in Photoshop. This tool is a great way of making really quick selections. In this video, I'm going to share 5 quick tips that you can use with the quick selection tool. Don't go away. Hi, I'm Barry Callister, founder and creator of photographersfreedom.com, giving you the time, gear, and skills to be the best photographer you can be. Welcome to my channel and thank you for looking at one of my videos. Here on my channel, I do photography tutorials, Lightroom and Photoshop tutorials, photography gear reviews, and other photography stuff. So if that sounds like something you might be into, why not hit subscribe and ding the notification bell so you don't miss any future videos from me. The quick selection tool is one of my favorite ways to select things in Photoshop. It's so quick and easy to use. In fact, I think it's the easiest selection tool in Photoshop. I'm now going to list in no specific order 5 quick tips for using the quick selection tool. These tips will help you get better and faster selections. There's also a few awesome tricks in there that you may not have known about before. If you watch till the end of the video, I'm going to let you know how you can view my in-depth tutorial on the quick selection tool. That video dives deep into the features of the tool and shows you how to use it. Right now, let's get into it. Okay, so here we are in Photoshop and I've got this image of a photographer standing on some rocks here. And if you want to download this image and follow along, there's a link in the video description. Now this is a fairly easy image to make a selection in because the background is practically white and the foreground is very dark. The only things that are possibly going to give us trouble is here around the tripod and the smaller things around his camera strap and stuff like that. So to open your quick selection tool, you can either press W on your keyboard or you come up here to this little icon here in the tools panel on the left hand side there. That's the quick selection tool. As you can see, Photoshop is telling us that. It also houses the magic wand tool. So if you see a little wand there, you've obviously been using the magic wand tool before, and you need to just left click and hold, and you can go back to the quick selection tool. All right, the first tip is about your brush hardness. Having a brush that is at 100% hardness will give you a much better and more defined selection. If you are trying to select with a soft brush, you'll just find that the tool behaves like a bit of a brat. It'll be just doing whatever it wants. It'll be selecting things that you don't want selected, and it just behaves weird. So setting your brush hardness can be done up here at your tools menu. Now you can see here you've got this circle icon and you've got these numbers below it. So that is your brush hardness and that is the size of your brush there. So if you click the little arrow there, that'll bring out this drop down menu. And here you can see your hardness. Currently I've got mine set to 100%. So if I pull that slider and go all the way back to zero, you can see the little icon up here changes to a soft edge. So that shows you that you have a very soft edge brush selected. You can also set the hardness of your brush by clicking and holding Alt or Option and clicking and holding your right mouse button, and you will see that the inside of the tool there fills with red. And if you drag your mouse cursor down to the bottom of the screen, you will get a harder brush, and if you push the cursor towards the top of the screen, you will get a softer brush. Now you can see that when the brush is set to 100%, that none of that red spills outside of the circle. So none of the red is coming outside of the tool, yeah? If I make it a soft brush, see how the red starts to bleed outside of the circle? That is what's going to happen to your selection. So what I will do is I will choose a 0% hardness brush, and I will just click once down here near these rocks. Now that looks like it's made a good selection. As far as the marching ants are telling us, it looks defined, it looks like it hasn't gone inside the rocks, it's done a very good job. But if I click select and mask up here, see this here, look at all this bleeding here, that there's how the selection has bled outside of where you wanted. I'll just go to overlay, and you can see down on the rocks here as well, see how the red is bleeding into those rocks there? So that's selecting part of the rocks, and that's going to give you a really, really bad selection. So I'll go back in here, I'll press Control D to deselect that. I'll make my brush 100% hard and I'll just click down in the same sort of area again. And you can see already how that has selected all of this area. When I had the brush set soft, it only selected that tiny bit down here in the left-hand corner. So already the brush is working better. And if we go into select and mask, and I'd select the overlay again, you can see down on the rocks here, we have a nicely defined selection. None of the red or selected area is bleeding into these rocks, which we did not want to select. And I can make my brush a bit smaller. If I go back here, make it a bit smaller, and I'll just click inside the tripod there, and you can see it does a fairly good job of that section too, and that there. So there you go, tip number one, 100% brush hardness will make the tool behave itself and you'll get a much better selection. Tip number two is small brush for small selections, large brush for large selections. Now this might sound pretty obvious because if we were trying to select this photographer here, we wouldn't want to have a very large brush because we'll click there and Photoshop will think, okay, you wanted other stuff outside of the photographer. So it's a good idea when you're selecting with the quick selection tool to have a small enough brush to fit inside of what you're selecting. So you can see there, when I had the small brush, it just selected within that area and Photoshop quickly picks up on what you want and you get the selection that you are after. Your brush size can also save you a bit of time. You'll notice here that I have a fairly small brush, and let's say I wanted to select all this white area around the photographer here. If I click once there, Photoshop only gives me that tiny selected circle there. If I do it again, I get another circle. If I do it again, I get another circle. If I click a fourth time, Photoshop goes, oh, okay, now I see what you were doing. You were trying to select all the white area. But if I had a large brush in the beginning and I click once, boom, see that? I got all of that area selected in one click instead of four. Of course, you can also do this by clicking and dragging. If you had a small brush, you could click and drag and it will give you that area. But personally, I'd rather do it in one click. Boom, it's done. Time saver. Tip number three is something that you may not have known about before. Once you have a selection with your quick selection tool, you can then grab that selection and move it anywhere you want within the document. So let's say if we just select our photographer roughly there. Now if you hold Alt or Option on a Mac and click and drag with your left mouse button, you can see you can cut that photographer out and we can put him down here on this rock if we want. And what you're left with over here where he used to be is a transparent section. It looks white right now because my background color is white, but that's actually an empty part of the document now. Tip number four is very similar to tip number three. This time we're not going to cut out the thing we want and move it. We're actually going to make a copy of it. So this is a way that you can duplicate things within your document. So let's select our photographer again. Just making a rough selection there. And now this time, instead of pressing just Control or Command and right clicking, we're going to press Control Alt on a PC or Command Option on a Mac. And you can see the cursor turns into two different arrows there. There's a black one and a white one. If we then left click with our mouse and drag, you can see we've made a copy of our photographer and we can put one of him there, and then we can copy again and we can put another one of him down there, and we could go on like this all day, but you get the point. Now tip number five is for users of Photoshop CC. That's version 2015.5.0 or newer, and this relates to select and mask. Select and mask is something that you can use after you've made a selection to modify your selection. You can apply feathering and contrast to the edges of your selection and so much more. But if you actually press select and mask before you select something, it makes it a lot easier and it will make a much better selection. So if I click select and mask here and I'll go to overlay view, now you can see over on the left-hand side here, you have your quick selection tool there, and you've got other tools there, including your lasso tool. So you select your quick selection tool there. You can do the same Alt or Option and sliding left or right to make it bigger. And then if I just want to select our photographer here, I'll make it small enough to fit inside him. And if I click and drag, you can see how quickly that made the selection. Look at this. It's so much more powerful than using the quick selection tool outside of select and mask. So if I make it small enough to fit in the tripod, look at that, one click and it's practically selected all of the tripod. Just click and drag, whoops, I've gone outside there. Just hold Alt or Option to subtract from the selection. This is not doing a good job because my brush is the wrong size. So that, you can see how much more powerful it is and how much more intuitive it is to use it within select and mask. So I mean, this is hard because of this tripod being so small. I really should zoom in a lot more. But there you go, that's a pretty good selection that I've got there by using select and mask before I make a selection. Now, I thought I would throw in a bonus tip here because, well, that's just the kind of guy I am. Now, this bonus tip here relates to quick mask mode. What quick mask mode does is it allows you to work with the selection as though it were a mask that you've already applied to a layer, which means that you can then use the brush tool to add or subtract to or from your selection. So let's make a selection of our photographer here again, just around the outside of him. We're selecting the white area. Now, to get to quick mask mode, you can either click this icon down here underneath your foreground and background color. There, you click that, that brings up the overlay there, and you're in quick mask mode. Or you can just simply press Q on your keyboard and it'll bring up quick mask mode also. Now, what you want to do is either click on your brush tool over here, or you can press B on your keyboard to bring the brush tool up. Now, what happens in quick mask mode is if your foreground color is set to black, it will add to the selection. If the foreground color is white, it will subtract from the selection. So make sure that your foreground and background colors are black and white, and you can do that by clicking this little icon here to reset them. And then to toggle between foreground and background color, you can either click these two arrows here, you see it swaps the foreground color from black to white. You can also press X on your keyboard to do that. So set your background, your foreground color to black, and you'll see if you click and paint, you are adding to the selection. Then if I toggle back to white as the foreground color, you can see I can take away from that selection. And if I just zoom in here, a great thing that you can do with this is this helps you to be able to do straight lines when you're selecting. Because what you can do with the foreground color set to black, I can click here on this straight edge of the tripod here, click once there, go down to here, hold shift, click again, and you see I get a straight line. So this is a really excellent way to work with your selection as if it were a mask. So quick mask mode, Q, just remember Q for quick mask mode. It's amazing. And to get out of quick mask mode, of course, just press Q again or press the icon. So there you have 5 tips for using the quick selection tool. They should help you out a little. If you have any tips of your own for using the quick selection tool, please pop them in the comments below. I am always keen for a new tip. Now, if you want more information about how to use the quick selection tool, check out this video right here. Before you leave, subscribe if you haven't already, click the like button and leave a comment if you're feeling chatty. Until next time, I'm Barry Callister for photographersfreedom.com. Get out there, take some wicked shots, and I'll see you soon.